Music Theory 101, The Treble Clef, brought to you by iLearnMusic.com. This is the musical staff. It is where we write notes in musical notation, and is the foundation of written music. This is the treble clef. It is used for higher pitched instruments, and tells us what the names of the notes on the staff are. This is important because with different clefs, the note names will change. However, for right now, let's just focus on the treble clef. With the treble clef, the names of the lines are E, G, B, D, and F. This is often remembered by saying phrases like, "Every good boy deserves fudge," or "Elvis goes bonkers doing flips," or any number of catchy phrases. For example, if we placed a note on the bottom line, the E line, it would be played as an E on a given instrument. This would be true of any line we put a note on. If we put a note on the G line, it becomes a G. A note on the D line becomes a D, and so on. The lines on the treble clef follow a particular pattern, and so do the spaces. The spaces are labeled F, A, C, and E. This is easily remembered because it spells the word face from the bottom up. As with the lines, if we place a particular note on a particular space, it becomes that note. An F placed on the F space becomes an F, and so on. Notes can also occur above or below the staff. This is achieved by adding lines to the notes, called ledger lines. Notes above the staff are added alphabetically, going up the musical alphabet, which only includes the notes A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. Moving up the musical alphabet, when G is reached, the next note will go back to A, then B, and so on. Notice that the order in which notes are added alternates between lines and spaces. Notes below the staff are added alphabetically, going down the musical alphabet. Notice that when the letter A is reached, the next note will be the letter G, then F, and so on.